is for an adult audience. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast may contain material that may be unsuitable for sensitive ears. Listener discretion is advised.
It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast is back, blowing in your earballs, doing what we do. It is the show that did invent, in fact, the color red.
In the earball?
In the earball, the red. Mm. And it's on Longbox.fm, as always, brought to you by Riley's Brewing.
Thanks, Riley's.
Oh, wow,
thanks,
Kevin Riley's. Disappeared.
I'll say it for you. Because
try the other mic, Kevin.
Kevin.
Okay, there we go.
Is this mic working, Kevin?
That mic is working, Kevin.
Oh, seriously? All right. Well, I'll just work both of them.
Double fist it.
There we go.
Power through it.
Yeah, this it's like is a Saturday night for you, isn't it?
Every night of the week, Saturday night.
This is what happens when Soundboy takes a break because I guess his dad is in the hospital. So, I went to the hospital and I did a show the next day and he's not even the one in the hospital. I don't, no respect, man.
Jeez. Great, can't great rely start. On people anymore.
Yeah. I like this.
Cut his pay.
Okay.
For the hospital?
He gets paid.
What can you divide zero by?
Zero?
Use Common Core.
Well, it feels like I need a safe zone because this answer is making me feel anxious. So I'll get back to you because I'm triggered right now. From the word trigger alone is a trigger word.
I think you need to be medicated.
You hear a gunshot?
Cycle, yeah. Does anyone have any medication?
I think there's plenty in the backyard.
I think I might.
As all things, everyone who's listening to the show, you can follow us up on Dirty Dowdy and Longbox and all things social media, the Facebook, the Twitters, the hashtag, of course, is DDP Live. And tonight we have a special one, hashtag SpanSpek. And that has to do with our guest tonight. We'll be talking with a couple guys talking about a music festival
coming
up.
Can you spell
up.
That for me?
SpanSpek.
E-K.
Well, there you go. E-K. That's why I asked, because it wasn't spelled normally.
Oh, well, fuck me.
And you don't have it up on the screen.
I'm working on it. Shut up. This is really hard to do. I have to babysit all of you guys and put a show together.
Dowdy
so.
Needs a day off.
Dowdy doesn't need a day off. Dowdy's had enough days off.
Poor guy.
Let me tell you, let's go with what we learned last week.
Oh, yes.
Now, it's time to showcase what we have learned in the last week.
Well, let me start off with, in the last week, as we have been talking about on the show, I have been sick, dealing with pneumonia and all that. I made a Facebook post that stated that, well, I came back from the doctor and it's official. I have full-blown AIDS. Skip the HIV, straight AIDS like Pedro Season 2 of Real World. That took on a life of its own. Even got into a fight with someone who said that he was mad at me for making light of a subject when looking at his Facebook page had just at the same time posted a picture that said, "Don't take things too seriously. Everyone's a pussy on the internet." So I did bring that up as a rebuttal, and then he pussy. Apologized. But anyways, old roommate sent
I don't
me
think
a text.
That's how it really went.
Old roommate sent me a text today that said, "Best part of the week. Having to explain to somebody that you do not, in fact, have AIDS." So, apparently, you can put anything on the internet and people will believe it.
AIDS is so nice.
That you don't have AIDS, they'll believe that craziness?
No. I do.
That he does. That, yeah, people are stupid. Mm. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's the internet.
That's why we have Kenneth.
Well, we did.
Kenneth will be back.
He's going to learn stuff. He's putting information in his head so he's not stupid.
Kenneth?
He's
There's
trying.
No, every piece of information that gets in his head gets knocked out during rugby.
Yeah. It's actually a prerequisite. That's what the training's all about.
What'd you learn, buddy boy?
Well, I learned that if I just lie about what I learned this week, it's a lot easier to come up with something.
That's true.
I'll take it.
Check it out. I learned that pancakes cure cancer. Mm. I learned all pigeons are homosexual. I learned Chinese food will give you the good kind of AIDS. And I learned
so you should give that to Dowdy.
Give me some yo Chinese.
And I learned jet fuel actually can melt steel beams. It's an amazing world.
Wow. Oh, Jesus,
man. In a post-9/11 world.
In this post-9/11 world.
You know that pops up every year on Google's trending. It shows up steel beams, jet fuel. It like peaks September and then
a big old question mark.
And then nobody looks at it again.
Yeah.
Also, amazingly, the stock for tin foil or aluminum foil rises during those periods of time, too.
Who would have thunk?
A lot of barbecues for Labor Day.
Speaking of thunking, Alex, what'd you thunk this week?
You know, I learned this week that people are idiots, but in a different way than I was expecting.
Wait, you just learned this?
No. I mean, I learn every week that people are idiots, but this one's a little different. There's a backlash on the internet.
What?
About the fact that there's a black guy as the lead role in a Star Wars movie.
Can't talk about black people, man.
Not I didn't cool. say what
you're white. You're not allowed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
White privilege. Fun. Check it. Check it now.
Don't worry. We'll talk about that in a little bit.
Don't you trigger me.
All right. You little tumblerina.
Okay. I feel safe.
Okay. You feel safe.
Go ahead. My feels are safe.
Do you have your ham sandwich?
I do.
Did you make it for yourself or did somebody make it for you?
What is going on?
Bully
free zone.
Huh?
Bully free.
I don't know. Am I the only one?
Oh my God. Who the hell cares?
Exactly. Exactly. That's where we're at. There was almost a news story on it, but I decided not to use it, thankfully.
Oh, I dare. I am worried to ask, but no, I'll come back to you. Cotty, start thinking. Jason, what did you learn this week?
I learned a couple things, but I did the math, and I've had 66% more men in my bed than women.
Continue.
No, that's it.
Like on accident or purpose?
I guess I invited them.
It's both, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's not both. It's on purpose.
No, I think that's on purpose.
Too many dicks in the bed?
That's a problem, apparently.
Were they wearing shorts or pants, at least?
Yeah.
They were
all clothed.
Okay.
Yeah. Pigeon.
You were one of them.
No, I didn't get in your bed.
Yeah.
No.
Wasn't it?
No. I knew better.
Yeah.
I didn't want to lay down in the snail trails.
He'd be paralyzed from the crotch down if you got in your bed.
I touched it before you had laid in it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Dowdy got in it.
Yeah, but I got in on delivery, so I thought I was pretty much safe. Unless he has got some Back to the Future ability to pre-jizz on an order.
That was the pre-crime. I went back.
When you ordered it, did you send cash and jizz in an envelope and ask, please spread this, then send it?
That was the special instructions on the order.
Okay.
I felt like I finally had to use that spot for something.
I've been in your spunk. Thank you.
You don't know about it, but you probably have been in a spunk.
I guess we're counting Desmond in this.
Yep, my son's been in your bed, which I just lost rights to him. Thank you.
Yep. Yeah, you probably shouldn't broadcast this. Oh, we're live. Oh, okay.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
And then it's just been Courtney and Mariah.
Yeah, Mariah's getting her. Nah. All right, Cotty. Time for you. What did you learn this week?
I learned that.
Go ahead. You know, we've learned now that you have your own theme music.
Is this Cotty's theme music?
Yeah.
Because she's so hardcore, gangster. Apparently.
You should be proud.
What did you learn?
GPS doesn't work if you run out of your GBs on your phone, day three.
Your what?
Here we go.
What?
Say that whole thing again.
So do you have the 3GB phone? Do you have the iPhone 3GB?
No.
How many GBs do you have?
I have one.
You've got one GB?
Oh, yeah. That's not even GBs. You said GBs and you lied.
Yeah, that's singular.
If you run out of your GB.
You had MBs.
Well, I kind of generalized it to make a point.
You need to get a phone with bigger gibs. that's the problem. You just need more gibs in your life.
Well,
more gibs for your gips?
If she's going to have more gibs, she needs to have more keshas in her paycheck.
It's true. More gibs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
you know, Kesha took the dollar sign out of her name because she's not doing drugs anymore, right?
Really?
Yeah.
She should put it back because she's worthless.
Well, I didn't say.
Yeah, her talent went away when she took that out.
No, when she stopped taking the drugs.
when she was born.
Did she also replace toothpaste? Or replace the jack fuck? With the toothpaste?
Replace toothpaste.
I know what song you're referencing, and I'm not going to. Go there. We're not going to talk about that.
Cotty's on drugs, everyone. That's what's wrong with her.
That's why she's talking.
And that's her show today. All right. Tell you guys back. What. Let's take a quick little break here. We're going to come back. We've got the Celebrity Clambake with Alex here, and I guess he's got some stuff that's unrelated to Lamar Odom, which makes me sad.
I'm so happy about that, by the way.
But I have
I'm
a chewy button.
I'm so glad you did not put that on. You didn't try to sneak one in on me.
Well, we'll see what happens next.
No, there's no Wookiee sounds this week.
There may be a Wookiee.
Chewy, the only Wookiee sounds you're going to hear are in the Star Wars trailer. Yeah.
Okay, you killed it. We're going to talk. We have a plan, supposedly, about Back to the Future Day, which is today. So, obviously, we've already referenced going back and jizzing on a pre-purchased bed. Mm-hmm. And Molestar's got some plans for that coming up, as well as our guest tonight. We'll talk to him right after the break. At the SpanSpek Festival, we got Cristobal Carrillo and Israel Flores. We'll be chatting with them, all this great music stuff. But right now, take a break. Come back to Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.FM.
Listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm. Listen and watch as we do our thing. And yeah, we encourage you to do it at home or on the go.
Yeah, cool. I want to do it.
Watch Longbox live on Ustream. Just search out Longbox on Ustream.com.
Hi, my name is Lindsay, and I'm searching for love.
I want to do music because I know people need my music. People need Kanye West albums.
My real apology to her will not come in the form of words.
When people say that I'm not like an airhead and things like that, it's not true at all.
All the stupid things celebrities do, it's the celebrity Clambake.
All right, we're back here at the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm, and as always, brought to you by Riley's Brewing.
Thanks, Riley's.
Okay, so to start off, we have a few guests here in the room. We got on the mic here. We got Cristobal Carrillo.
Yeah,
you know what?
Cristobal Carrillo.
We got that dude and that other dude.
Now, Carrillo. To be fair, I just translated his name because my name is Christopher.
You're absolutely right.
So Cristobal Carrillo and Israel Flores.
How you doing?
Did I butcher any of that any more than I could have?
No, that was good.
I like how you pronounce Carrillo, but you say Cristobal, not Cristobal.
I know.
I'm selective.
I'm white.
You're half white is what's going on.
Well, he speaks Spanglish.
My son's half Mexican, so I feel I'm grandfathered.
He's not half Mexican. Yeah,
he's grandfathered.
Peruvian, yeah. I thought.
No, he's half Mexican. No, the Peruvian. I never got in that.
Oh, got it.
Yeah, that was his wife. He didn't have sex with her.
Yeah, that everyone else did. And
sad but true.
I guess that's an X.
And we got another guy on the mic that probably won't talk at all if we all have our way. Nick, he's the cable monkey at one of our job sites that we... We work with this guy.
Don't lose your job. Just
so
stay right there.
He'll sit here and not talk at all and drink beer. So, anyways, Kevin, let's do this. Give me the first clam bake.
Who?
Alex.
Yeah,
my
I'm
bad.
Over here, dog.
Yeah, you got the wrong person there, motherfucker.
I'm drunk.
Already?
No.
You've had like a third of one beer.
No, I've had a sip of a beer, but a lot of medication.
Oh, okay. You're drunk on meds. We're going to start off with Marshawn Lynch and Fred Jackson. They were seen driving at high rates of speeds, and Fred Jackson actually crashed his car. So there were some witnesses that saw both cars that they were apparently driving at high rates of speed. This was just outside of Seattle, next to their practice facility the other day, and Fred Jackson crashed his car. He ran into a planter box and a
Would
stop sign.
Would it be fair to say I'm sorry, Mr. Jackson?
You're not for real. Fred was in a black Corvette, and
why
does
it got to be a black Corvette?
Lynch was in a white sports car.
African American Corvette. Excuse me, it's 2015, sir.
Black diversity matters.
Yeah, he lost control and smashed into the
black Corvette.
Large planter box. God damn it.
Power through. You got this.
Richard Sherman stopped by on his way home, and Marshawn Lynch drove off uninjured, but Fred Jackson went back to the Seattle Seahawks facility to get checked out by the doctors.
I can never hear the name Miss Jackson or...
You can never hear the name Jackson and not think Miss Jackson?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's a great song, but
Wait, were they drunk or anything? They just crashed.
No, this was right after practice.
Ah, okay.
This is the middle of the day yesterday.
So they were blackout drunk.
So they were drunk.
Probably they were super drunk. They might have been. Yeah. They were just driving like idiots.
Maybe he got distracted with Skittles.
Could have been Skittles. Could have been Skittles. All right, enough about a black guy wrecking a car. We're going to talk about a black guy wrecking his kid's life. Tyga.
To be fair,
Which one's more valuable?
Wait till I say his son's name. Tyga was in the news. Well, it was more on Snapchat. He took a picture with his son dancing around his living room, and on his living room table there was a little pile of green stuff that looks a lot like marijuana.
That's called the weed, man.
Looks like cat throw up to me.
There was also a package of Swisher Sweets nearby. King Cairo was his name, playing in the living room. That's his son with his ex-girlfriend.
That's his name?
Did I stutter? His name is King Cairo.
Wow.
I want to say it, that's even better. The three-year-old was within arm's reach of the pile, and which was sitting on the coffee tile next to him. Tiger's baby mama is Black China, who's been in the news as of late, but she's not really that important. It's just more stupid than real. Tiger did remove it from his Snapchat, but it definitely, you know, it's like the Madonna effect. As soon as you bring attention to it, asking someone to remove it, it ends up everywhere.
Is it possible somebody hacked that weed on his table?
You know, I would say that could be superimposed, but it's not.
Yeah, someone just hacked it.
Hacked it on there.
You know what? That probably wasn't his weed. That was probably the kid's weed.
Speaking of hacks, let's go to Las Vegas and Britney Spears.
She's a special woman. How dare you?
So she's got the hardest working dancers in the Vegas Strip. The other night, I think she was performing on Saturday night at the Planet Hollywood where she's got her show. Something came unhooked or ripped on the back of her outfit.
It was her penis.
It finally fell off?
In the back of her outfit?
You tuck it.
She got to tuck it back.
That's where it's at, yeah.
So you're saying her dick's so big it goes up to her shoulder?
You know, if Jason tucked his dick, he'd have a small tail.
You've never seen Britney Spears' penis?
I'd be a platypus.
I'm kind of glad I haven't.
Well, you should Google it sometime.
I'm good on that.
Britney's dick?
Yeah.
Okay.
They rallied to keep her ass from falling out on stage. It was pretty nice. They were stitching her up while she continued dancing and singing well.
That would have been nice about like 20 years ago.
Lip dancing and lip singing?
Yeah. No, actual foot dancing and lip syncing.
No.
She danced with her feet. I hope she doesn't dance with her lips, I guess.
Does she foot sync?
In theory. So speaking of someone who actually has talent, Eddie Murphy was...
Had.
No, he still has talent. He still does. He just hasn't been on stage for like 28 years.
Reasons?
Because he didn't want to be on stage?
Yeah, that's usually what happens when you stop getting gigs.
He's a black man that made a lot of money. He did a couple horrible movies. I'm not going to say he didn't. But he was at the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C., and he received the Mark Twain Prize for Humor. The best part about it, though, was during his acceptance speech, he brought up Bill Cosby, who... also had won the Mark Twain Prize for Humor.
And he is an amazing man. Do not disparage him.
And so he started making jokes about Bill Cosby to the point he even did an impression that was so spot on, making fun of the fact of when people called for Bill Cosby to give back all of his trophies. And then it was pretty entertaining. I watched the video. It was worth it.
Speaking of trophies... If you try to date rape a girl and the drugs don't work, do you get a participation trophy for that?
It's called getting arrested.
Is that considered the police record as the participation ribbon?
Maybe.
I think masturbation is the participation trophy.
Yeah, really, though.
Well, then I'm a participant.
And it's really interesting that he decided to do that now, considering back in February he refused to do Cosby for SNL's 40th anniversary special, but... Norm MacDonald said it was because he didn't want to kick a man when he was down. No. Apparently he's down far enough that he can't kick him.
No one drugged him.
Can't reach anymore.
He's not on the floory.
So speaking of someone with no talent, Iggy Azalea was in the news, but only because she cut her fucking hair off and she looks like an ugly man in the picture.
Oh, yeah. To be fair, she started off as an ugly man.
Oh, no, I know. It looked like she was wearing a wig and then she cut all of her hair off. She just looks absolutely ridiculous. She doesn't really look like a glam rapper anymore. She arrived at LAX on Saturday, smiles, wearing what looks like a Letterman's jacket. But not long before, I mean, that other picture on the right, that's from like
she looks
the
like,
15th.
Like Ron Howard.
She looks like Max Headroom a little bit.
You know what? That's a great... Oh, man. She
good
looks
reference.
Like
hold on to that.
Broke-ass Max Headroom. speaking of headroom, Bot Barker was in the news. He took a nasty fall. He was walking down the sidewalk and split his head open, 1.5-inch gash. The 91-year-old was on a walk around 10:30 a.m. near his Hollywood home yesterday, and he tripped on the sidewalk because that's what old people do.
Yeah, but he's immortal.
I heard it was confirmed he had a stick mic with him.
That wouldn't surprise me, in all honesty.
I'd like to think that that was just a fake mic the whole time. No, like, it's just a boom mic floating above his head.
It's just a little magic wand.
He's just holding it, like, blah, 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 $10.
He uses it to violate Bob's beauties.
You know, there are stories about that, but we're not going to bring that up. He went to Cedars-Sinai's hospital. He's resting now. He was actually, you know, helped out pretty quickly. There happened to be some LAPD officers nearby. So I guess to get help from LAPD officers when you fall down in LA, you have to be a 91-year-old white man.
No, you have to be Bob Barker, and he gets help no matter what.
A 90-year-old white
man.
That man is a national treasure.
So speaking of national treasures, Jaden Smith.
Nope.
Oh, God.
Nope.
Your segues are awesome.
Yeah. Nope. Nope.
I thought you were going to say Trayvon Martin.
No, no, no. Jaden Smith plans to disappear in 10 years.
Disappear?
Yeah. Just like not be around.
Can you do it now?
That's what I was thinking myself when he said it. Apparently, this was in an interview with GQ he had, and they asked where I'll be in 10 years, and he said, gone. And they're like, what do you mean? He's like, well, no one will know where I am in 10 years. It's like, what the fuck is the point of saying you're going to be gone if they don't understand that? They'll see me pop up and they'll be like, where did you come from? No one will know. No one will know where I'm at.
We're so fucked.
No one will know what I'm doing. I've been planning this since I was 13, apparently. He's been planning this for a while.
Is there anything that we planned for at 13 that we're doing now?
Getting inside of a woman.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, but you're still not doing that.
Yeah, it's a 50-50 around this room.
Yeah. Yeah, so he goes on to talk more jibber-jabber and garbage. He said he's going to try to be like Banksy, but with art installations. I don't know how well that'll work.
When you reference Banksy as a goal for your life, go to hell and die.
You know, but Banksy actually does some good art. I don't know what Willow's going to... I mean, art. Him and Willow are going to do. But the
if
funny
I
thing
jizz
is...
If I on a street sign, I can call that art.
Yeah, but he's getting paid for that shit.
Yeah.
Think about
no,
it.
No, no, no.
It's the ultimate scam.
He's not getting paid.
He's getting money. It's genius.
But
I'm gonna go jizz on tonight.
Damn it!
I think you should jizz on a wall tonight.
He might. Anyway, and then he goes on to talk about how he and his sister Willow are scientists, and everything that they do is a scientific test upon humanity. And luckily, we're put in a position where we can affect large groups of people. Human beings at one time. Yes, this is just absolutely retarded.
I hate everything about this.
That's so great. It's so great. It's so bad.
Prediction. He gets cast as the Fresh Prince in the remake here in like 10 years.
You know what? Yeah. I hope he's dead in 10 years and that's why he's gone.
Maybe he can see the future.
Early OD.
Yeah. I think that's what's going to happen.
Mm. I think Dowdy's is much more realistic. Except it'll be like a year and a half because somebody just heard that and they're like, oh my God, it's gold.
Trademark. Yeah. Trademark.
You know what? But
too late.
They don't have I don't know about who's going to be like a good Uncle Phil replacement because they can't use the same guy.
Because he dead.
Is he dead? Yeah. He's dead.
He did.
James
Uncle
Earl
Heart
Jones.
Attack. James Earl Jones.
Samuel Jackson. He's every
guy. Oh, motherfucker. Yeah.
Is the guy who played Uncle Winslow still alive?
Carl Winslow? I don't know.
That's a good question.
I think that'd be good.
That's a good question.
Now, we would have heard about that.
Nah, he was too goofy. I don't think he could be the serious judge.
I think he could bring the gravitas.
What about the Family Matters dad?
I think it's going to be like the Fresh Prince of Philadelphia. He's going to be like, son, you're too spoiled and rich white kid, and he's going to send him to Philadelphia to get some street smarts.
Oh, they're going to do like the Welcome to America flip? You go from royalty to poverty?
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
Okay, so the father from Family Matters takes over.
Oh,
that's the uncle.
No, not him.
I still see Samuel Jackson doing it.
That would be Samuel L. Jackson in Philadelphia. Yeah.
Yeah, if you need some thug street life.
Mm-hmm.
He's not fat enough, though.
It doesn't have to be. No.
He has to be.
He's a really good actor.
You don't have to be a fat guy to be. He's going to be the thug dad. He's going to be the dad who's been through some shit, you know?
He's going to be his character.
Some of our best thugs are overweight.
So since we're done talking about people who don't know what they're talking about, we're going to move on to more people who don't know what they're talking about. Bishops in the Catholic Church admit we don't know much about sex. We need married advisors. So they're admitting that they don't know much about
counselors.
Sex. Yes, they need. Apparently, they do. I don't know. Maybe it's with them and little boys. Bishops participating in the Vatican Synod on the Family have admitted they don't know much about sex, and they need help of lay people to fully understand marital intimacy. Now, I just don't know if they need help talking about intimacy. They go on to say many fathers don't talk about the beauty of sexuality with their children. Which you actually caused your...
I think you just read that right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sexuality with your children. Because why else would you make them?
Yeah, the church is entering not in this, not doesn't want to be involved in this role. But that same clergy that said that also said the clergy's response to the sexual abuse scandal demonstrated a lack of expertise in sexuality and psychology to make good decisions. So they're saying they're the people who are supposed to be like the moral compass, and they don't understand how to make
What's their sex education? Like little Timmy, first you take this lollipop, then you take this lollipop, and then you do 17 Hail Marys?
Let's get them to get on...
yeah, probably.
Okay.
Let's get them on...
I don't know. I'm not Catholic.
On Tinder.
Who's Catholic here?
No, they need to be on Grindr.
There you go.
Because that's where they'll fit in.
Can you imagine if you matched with the Pope?
Oh.
You're like,
you'd have to
I'm
take
bored.
That, right? You'd have to take that date. You'd
have to,
I would totally fuck the Pope.
Would you be like... doing something against God? Would you fuck the Pope?
Would you fuck the Pope?
No, I'd be close to God.
Totally fuck the Pope. How could you resist that hat?
I'd put it on the glass.
That's 1 degree of separation from Jesus, right there.
No,
that's true. It's like you're fucking.
Yeah, it's supposed
Jesus
to be. Yeah,
old.
Yeah, you're supposed to be. You know,
yeah, you get to be Eskimo brothers with Jesus.
You could be like the Romans. You could be fucking Jesus.
Heyo. Anyway, speaking of people making bad decisions,
you try so hard at that.
These segues are.
They're horrible. They're great. No, they're so great, but they're so horrible.
You're doing great.
A lesson learned this weekend. Wild West gunfight reenactments are great, except for when the ammunition is live.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, I mean.
It's just murder otherwise.
No, Old West reenactment. That's dedication to your art.
How many times can you get away with that before it's murder?
You know.
None?
I'm almost there.
Okay.
Zero, actually.
Old I'm West excited.
Reenactments, Civil War reenactments, you know, all kinds of those battle reenactments. They're great.
White people shit.
Especially for the guys who get dressed up for it. You know, we have the biggest Civil War reenactment
who
on the West Coast.
Who missed the days
here
of fighting for slavery.
Fresno. It's exciting.
Is the
Park.
Civil War thing at Kearney Park, is that just a yearly desperation and wishing you could be around during slavery?
Are there any black people that go to that?
Protesting.
It's not far from where a lot of them live on the West Side. You got to talk in the mic.
Yeah, new guy on the mic.
I don't think it's on.
It's good. Yeah. No. You're gonna lose your job.
I did it right.
Oh, wait, now try it. Now try.
You're one shot.
Yeah, you are.
I am. Yeah. No. It's a pretty hilarious time. I did security out there one time, and there's a bunch of kids that are all dressed up like that. I mean, it's hardcore. They really go out on it, and then they just get pretty hammered at the end of the night and hang out. Since I was doing security, I wasn't able to get completely hammered with them. But
you had a beer.
They passed out, and you know I went to town with the Sharpie and drew a bunch of penises on their face. And
of course,
that sounds
it was pretty hilarious.
That's excellent.
I wonder what did they use
penis?
In the Civil War
you know,
for
the
Sharpie?
The best way is because
charcoal?
They thought they were in the
probably
Civil War
dicks.
That they didn't shave, they didn't do anything, so they woke up not looking in a mirror, not doing it. So they woke up with giant penises on their face, walked around all day in front of people, crowds, everything with a giant Sharpie penis.
That sounds awesome.
Bravo, sir.
So it gets better. Yeah, on Sunday afternoon, what should have been a great spectacle. There was it was a redo of the OK Corral gunfight in Tombstone, Arizona, and bystanders were shot after live ammunition was used. One of the actors was late to the show, and his weapon was not checked before the reenactment. I think the first rule of like gun safety is you make sure it's not loaded.
Well, then you don't get the cool sound effects.
Right. No, that's why you have to make sure it's not loaded so you can put the non-live. Ammunition.
No, he was late. He ain't got time.
He just
that.
He didn't want to use.
Here comes Alex there, with the rules of gun safety.
Yeah,
hey, you know what?
Don't
I fired
shoot
a gun.
Each other and kill each other. Guys.
I mean, it's not that complicated.
It's the George Zimmerman rules.
We
of
don't
want
to hear about the Chicago rules about guns.
I said I was just glad that he didn't use CGI.
Oh gosh. They stopped the show immediately and relieved the gentleman
real.
Of his weapon. They're gonna stop future gunfights unless it can be determined that all weapons are safely loaded with blank ammunition as required. So
you mean just check them?
Yeah. You mean like do what they should have done in the first place?
Right?
Common sense.
Like, come on, guys. That guy's fatally wounded. Check
yeah, they're revolvers. They're the old school revolvers.
Come
so
on,
you have
guys.
To manually unload them.
Cool, man.
You go home and think about what you did.
So last but not least in our stupid news, this is one of my absolute personal favorites. A student driver crashes into driving school in Washington State.
You pass. Thanks to Common Core.
Common Core driving?
Fucking A. A student driver arriving to take a driving test crashed into the driving school in Bellevue, Washington.
That's amazing.
The accident happened Friday morning at Bellevue 911 Driving School and DOL Testing.
So they didn't
center.
Have to call anyone, right? It was right there.
Yeah, they got it all covered.
Apparently.
And they have a beautiful Shasta dispenser.
Yeah.
They do. That's
I'm
pretty
glad
baller.
That wasn't damaged.
How old is Shasta? Oh, man.
There were no injuries to the driver, occupants of the building, or anybody else. Or the Shasta cola machine inside. Talk about that. That's
the
great.
The most important thing here.
The student failed. She failed her test. She was a 27-year-old foreigner.
What?
She was like a 20.
Wait, can we guess the race?
Hold on.
No.
Do we know the race?
I don't
Asian.
Know the race.
Damn it.
It's Asian.
No, she wasn't Asian.
It's Asian.
Indian.
Yeah,
I'll name them all. I don't give a fuck.
It was all the races. So that's all the garbage and celebrity news I have for this week.
Yay. All right.
I'm glad I'm done with that.
I like being on cue with the sound effect.
Did any of them
no,
die?
We're getting there.
There we go.
So anyways, we're going to take a quick break here. We're going to come back to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast here on Longbox.fm. We're going to talk with our guests, Christopher and Israel.
Yeah.
Damn it.
I got
whites of five.
Why don't you just call him Christopher Ball?
You can call me Chris. Christopher Ball.
We're going to...
Chris Ball.
Christopher Ball.
Chris's Ball.
We're going to mix some brown in on the mic to help this out.
Goddamn Chris with ball in my name.
Jesus Christ. So we're going to be talking with them about the SpanSpek Festival coming
balls
up here.
Balls in my mouth.
And as all things, you can tune in. You can chat with us. Fuck it. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
You're listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm.
Hi, this is Al Pacino, and when I am taking a shit, I listen to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
Podcast on longbox.fm, and as always, brought to you by Riley's Brewing, who we actually got some of the root beer in here.
The hard root beer.
Hard root beer, and Cotty is actually drinking a beer
and liking it.
Is that an endorsement? What would you say, C?
She doesn't like any beer but Riley's.
Okay. And again, as always, Cotty's useless. So anyways, we got our guest in tonight.
At least she's not pointless.
And we have another person on the mic joining us to help support Cotty, her friend Melissa. She's actually a loud Mexican to balance Cotty. So between the two of them, we have a mediocre Mexican woman.
A mediocre Mexican?
Yeah.
By statistics alone, one of them are pregnant. No.
Actually, I think three of them are somehow.
Well, okay.
That'd be me.
Wait, can you talk on the mic?
Are you
though?
Pregnant?
I think yes, your pregnant baby is
Wait,
pregnant.
What's the ratio of 4 Mexicans to 5 white people? I'm assuming you're all white.
It's called California.
It's California.
Taking over.
It's actually 5
to
5.
Mexicans.
It's even.
This is off.
All right, so we're gonna try to help out during this segment. Now, Gotti, since you don't talk, we gave you something to do. It involves a lot of talk.
No. Nope.
You're going to help translate this segment for our Spanish-speaking audience?
No.
No?
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 Yeah.
I can do that.
All that build up for nothing. Okay.
We'll let Melissa do it.
We have a volunteer.
I'm a very fluent Mexican.
You speak fluent Mexican?
I'm a fluent Mexican.
You're Mexican.
And Melissa,
day.
Can you be on the show and not Cotty from now on? I'm already liking it better.
I don't know. I don't
Are you
know
talking
how that's
about the show
affect
or
you in the
bedroom
later
bedroom.
On. Bedroom. I wouldn't go there.
Well,
it's no worse than he's already doing.
When you're at rock bottom,
can't go any lower.
Anyways, our guest tonight, Christopher Carrillo.
You've just given up on it.
No.
And Israel Flores. They're the guys behind the SpanSpek Festival, the music and arts festival.
Hello.
Going on at Saturday, October 24th. It's where at?
In Orosi, California.
And next question, where?
I said fucking Orosi, California, motherfucker.
And for the rest of the world who doesn't understand what you just said, can you translate?
Can I get directions?
That was not Spanish, I swear.
It's not Spanish. Is it Spanish?
I don't think so.
I think it's right by the beach.
Is it close to the beach?
By Reedley Beach.
Reedley Beach?
Reedley Beach?
Reedley.
Isn't Orosi in Tulare County?
That is correct. Who said that? That mysterious voice. Where the fuck is that coming from? There you are.
Yeah, there you go.
It's very ominous.
You're absolutely right. Northern Tulare County, in between Visalia and Fresno. It's a small little rural town.
And it's going to be the Orosi Memorial Hall.
Yes, 41645 Road 128.
And you didn't read that off of anything. You have this memorized.
I have that memorized.
And it's craft beer on tap for all those 21 and over. And
delicious Riley's IPA.
Yes, apparently.
From Riley's Brewing Company.
It's
with
pretty good, then.
Mexican
huh?
lady on the front. Looks like it's sombrero.
And let's see. The list of bands here. You got Lance Canales and the Flood, Light yes. Thieves, Kaleidoscope, Basura, Waterbox Incorporated, The Gilligans, Green Giant, Nesto Jukebox, and Sanex.
Yes.
Cool. Got
An
it.
Amazing lineup. Well, did you know Lance is from Orosi?
No.
Do you know who Lance is?
Yes. We play him here on Longbox.
Yeah, no.
He's a hometown guy. He's coming back for first time in a while.
How long? Well, I know I've been seeing a lot on him with the on the online world, the interwebs. He's doing
Facebook?
That newfangled interwebs, yes.
Wasn't right. he down in Austin for the Austin City Music Festival?
Yeah.
He was.
That guy's all over the place. And he's going to tour Europe in a few months, apparently. Right? Is that what he said?
Yeah, that's what he said.
Yeah.
Apparently he's done it in 2009, and he's going to do it again. With this new record, which is good, by the way. You guys can listen on Spotify, I think, or just buy it.
The Blessing and the Curse. Yeah. It's a very good album.
Or just listen to Longbox and, you know.
Yeah. Do you play a song
yep.
from a new album?
Yep.
There you go. Listen to Longbox.FM. Don't buy shit.
Don't buy it. Yeah.
Just
oh, wait,
listen
buy
to
it.
Longbox.
Poor
good to
Lance.
See you support your artists.
Yeah.
How long has the SpanSpek been going on? Because I've heard this name for a while.
10 years.
Diaz?
10
years. 10 años.
10 años?
Right.
Sí.
Cari translate. 10 años.
No, Cari's not doing it.
Años. No.
Yeah. Wait, I forgot your name. What was your name again?
Melissa.
I'm going to write that down on my list.
Años is Spanish for anus.
Yeah.
Right?
That is correct.
Close.
That is correct, white
no,
boy.
No, it's Spanish for a whale's anus.
Whale anus. Yes. That's what I was going with.
But 10 years, man. No other festival has gone on that long.
Locally, anyway.
Locally, anyway. It's gone on as long as this.
What else can we expect at the festival?
A lot of good food, a lot of good art from Fresno and Tulare County artists.
We have about 15 or so artists, 8 bands, 3 DJs. Gosh.
And then the smoking burrito. I guess have you heard of the taco truck throwdown?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
You've heard of that?
Yeah, of course.
Have you heard of the smoking burrito? Got second place at the taco truck throwdown.
At the latest one?
Why didn't we get first place?
At the latest one. They got second place.
Why didn't we get first
place? Why didn't we get first place?
Because white people voted.
Who did get first place? Premio Mayor.
El Premio Mayor. We couldn't get them. Yeah. You know why? Because they don't have an online presence. I didn't know how to contact them.
Oh, they've got a store.
Yeah, they do.
I want to see a taco. I
don't have time to go to Fresno. I'm in Orosi all the time.
That's your own fault.
I want to see a taco truck with an app where you can order ahead of time.
No, they're not. They don't have internet where they go.
Yeah, that ain't going to happen.
Yeah, I was going to say,
it's
is it like a Taco
Mexican,
Bell where you,
no
you place your order ahead of time and you're just going to show up with your...
That's the small price you pay
you can't
for the
do that with the taco
Mexican
truck.
Food on the planet.
That exactly, see?
All right, what else can you, before we get to Molestar's questions here, what else can you tell us about the festival and what we can expect, and make promises that you can't keep by all means?
Just pretend you're like the president.
No, you go ahead.
Free health care for everyone?
First of all. All proceeds from the festival go to fund high school scholarships to Orosi High School, and they also fund artist commissions from local artists, and we also put on local concerts every year with the funds from the festival. So if you go, you're supporting community involvement.
And you're taking down the white man.
And we're taking down the white man.
You know.
Starting with you guys.
Black fist up in the air, man. I support you.
Wait, did you say white fist up in the air?
No, brown fist.
Brown.
It's the one he has tucked away underneath his bed.
I see what's going on.
Where's the politician
at? It's latex.
Shh. Let's not talk about
this.
It's almost. But you're supporting kids going to college.
By having a black fist in his bed.
By supporting the festival.
Oh, by going to the SpanSpek.
By going to the festival.
Right, that's what I meant.
There you go. I like that. It happens. Better.
As long as the kids go to school.
Yeah, right?
That's important, right?
Kids going to school is good. Look, it's good.
Well, let's get to the important questions here.
As
the
always.
Ones that will get our audience to know and decide whether or not to go see your festival. Now, you guys represent everything SpanSpek.
So where are these questions coming
the
from?
The way you
from
answer these man? Questions.
Kevin.
Master.
Which one's or Kevin Matt. Again? Oh, shit. Let
one,
me
one of us.
The white one at the end.
You get okay. Go on, Nick.
All right,
Mr. Nick.
No, he's over here.
I'm Nick.
Wait, what the fuck?
Are yeah. you saying we all
let
look
me,
the same?
Let me adjust my list. I had you on the wrong side. No, you know
no,
what? Because you changed your seat.
Yeah, they moved.
Yeah,
white people
that
are sneaky
loud.
Like that.
Plus,
that
every
is
white
loud.
Person's name
but I was
is
never
Nick.
Sitting there.
All right, so what's your name again?
Nick.
Nick.
Wait, no. I'm Mole Man. You're not getting that.
Where do we?
I'm Mole Man. Ask your questions, Mole Man.
You know he's confused as we switched seats. I was over there.
I got you. Totally.
Right, he was on that side, so it was reversed.
Israel, you're gonna ask these questions, right?
Education.
All right, here we go. Israel,
keep
the
focus, guys.
Less inebriated one.
This one is for Israel. Israel, when you talk, make sure you know. Project too, you know, get out there.
Oh,
all right. So Israel, which one of you would get more poon from a blind chick?
The drummer always does.
The drummer always gets more poon. I'm
Chris
a drummer.
Chris is a drummer, so he'll get that.
That means I get more poon.
He's got
from
blind
chick?
Or not.
The blind chick rhythm.
I feel very good looking.
So Cristobal, do you
so
know
a blind girl would know.
Plus, there's more
you
to feel.
I'm not good looking, but I feel good looking.
You, feel
you know what I mean?
Important.
You
exactly.
understand?
Right, like do you have that in your Tinder profile?
I don't have it in my profile.
That's how good looking he is.
That's how good looking. I don't need it.
I don't think it would be very
people helpful. Swipe right on me physically. They just like this.
Get out of my face.
I'm rubbing my chest right now at the moment. Get out of my face.
All right, Israel. Yes. Same question, but the chick has normal vision, but she also has no teeth.
Oh, my God.
You wouldn't nail that shit. Israel's really good looking, I have to say.
And clearly a slut.
And clearly a slut.
Yeah. And Chris is drunk, but I go with no teeth. That'd be me.
Meth head?
You went to Gummer?
Yeah. You'd go with the meth head?
Gummer, yeah.
Not necessarily meth head, but probably.
She's great. In Fresno.
Yeah.
She couldn't buy it.
You're a slut!
Yeah, she's a slut. Thank you, Rush Limbaugh.
So am I, apparently.
Nothing like a GJ?
Gum
job?
Gum
job. GJ.
No, G. Yeah, GJ. All right.
Usually get those from the GILF.
Yeah.
Cristobal. Next question.
Yes. Yes, mole man.
Do you know what a snuff film is? And if not, do you have a tarp I can borrow and maybe a girl who wants to be famous?
I heard, do I know what a snuff film is?
Mm-hmm.
That's where like people get killed. And it's real, right? Is that my understanding? That's my understanding.
It depends on your interpretation of art.
And you get turned on by it.
The real question is, do you have a tarp? Can he borrow?
Do I have a tarp? I don't have a tarp. That's the actual
he needs
question.
A tarp.
Yeah.
Why did you do that snuff film stuff in there?
I
have a tarp you can borrow. Yes.
If you use a canvas instead of a tarp, does that make it art?
Yes. You have red. A red tarp.
Can you get away with it as a legal defense?
I think so. Yeah.
Let's try that out. Let's see how
it goes.
Let's call my lawyer.
The tarp's really more for convenience after the film. You figure that out. It's better to learn that from somebody else.
Mole man, have you seen a snuff film?
Huh? Well, I mean,
well,
you know.
We've been on the internet.
We've turned the table, Small Man.
Whoa.
Now
Whoa.
I'm asking a question.
Small man.
Have you seen Small Man? Have you seen?
I mean, I don't want to be too specific, but yeah, I've seen like 40 of them.
You've seen 40 snuff films.
Because he seeks them out.
It's actually like his Windows startup sound.
Are you buying them? Are you buying them or downloading them?
I've got a background maker for my. I've got a background maker app for my phone. It just all
right, so this guy is like for sure a serial killer, right, guys?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's
all
cops.
No, I don't kill him. I mean, I don't watch that stuff. That's illegal.
Yeah.
All right, here's a serious question. Who would win in a fight? Christopher walking on a Segway with truck nuts fist fighting Patrick Stewart on a longboard with what I call Prius labias.
What?
What do you think is real?
Exactly what you think it is.
It's the vagina
almost always
you stick on the back.
Truck nuts, so it's, I don't know.
Prius See, look, labia. I love Patrick Stewart, but I think you have to give it to Christopher Walken with the truck nuts on the Segway. How can you beat
That's the part
walking?
That's throwing me off, the truck nuts on the Segway.
Yeah. It's called a counterbalance.
Wouldn't they drag on the floor? They would drag on the floor.
Maybe. Maybe I that's a disadvantage.
It
that's
happens.
That is a disadvantage that I think about it.
Okay, Patrick Stewart.
Wait, what was the labia part with Patrick Stewart?
Prius labias.
He had Prius
Doesn't
labias.
Doesn't every Prius come with labias?
What does that mean?
Prius called drivers.
That's
yeah.
a standard feature.
No, it's just, yeah, it's just a hanging pair of labias.
A hanging pair of labias?
Yeah, it looks like beach.
I would feel like labias would glide easier on the floor, so maybe he would win. He'd have the speed advantage.
Snail trails, though.
Yeah. Well, what's wrong with snail
what if they're in sand dunes?
wouldn't they create drag,
what
though?
If they're in a sand dune?
Yeah.
That's not good for the batteries on the Prius.
You're adding too many variables on this fight. I don't know. Maybe it'd be a draw.
I have no idea what the fuck is going on right now.
I think it might be a draw.
I think it might be a draw.
I mean, we broke it down logically.
Well, man, I think it'd be a draw.
That was scientifical.
Yeah. That was scientific.
It was scientific. Yeah. We established that.
Thing. I Googled science. That's what they said.
Yeah.
All right. So this one's back to Israel. Who would win in a fight? A pirate with tennis elbow or a midget with massive camel toe?
Ooh, the midget. Just because I like to see him on the podium.
Of course,
yeah.
He'd be normal height.
Of course,
yeah. You'd think he was like a real person.
Would he hold like a half-size black fist in the air when he wants? Maybe.
That's
why,
interesting.
Why are you going back to the black fist?
Because that's what all champions have.
It's an Olympic thing.
Yeah.
That was kind of a softball.
It's Carl Lewis, you know.
You are not a champion.
All right, here's a good one for you though, Israel.
Yeah.
Ooh. How long would Dowdy last in prison?
Are we going with seconds, minutes, hours?
I do have a. Are we talking like California? You know, full of Mexicans
which
prison?
Which prison?
I mean, the most likely prison for him to end up in.
Corcoran.
I don't know.
That's
how
where
many,
Courtney works.
Chris, how many listeners do you think you have in prisons? Because that might, you know.
No, you know what? I'll let you guys answer this first, and then I'll give you some backstory, and then you can answer again.
Oh, so there.
That sounds like
so he's been
prison
somewhere.
Before.
He's
yeah.
going to have a permanent marker
he's done
with
time.
A swastika on his forehead.
He has
going to get with the white
been in prison.
Yeah.
I would give him the benefit of the doubt. I don't know.
You think he'll do well?
I think he'll do well, yeah.
I think he'll do very well.
Yeah.
He would
You're
sex
a talker.
Himself out.
I think he will
do well.
I think
do
he
well
would,
is
yeah.
like a butt plug.
Turn into a girlfriend real quick.
I feel like you'll make people laugh and they'll keep you around.
It'd be he'll be known as El Gran Cañon.
Let's not kill this Leno. He's funny.
Wait, what's the backstory? Tell us the backstory.
Yeah. What's translation with
When were you in prison, Dowdy?
Well, it's just county. 7 days.
7 days in county for what?
Did this include
DUI?
DUI?
Alcohol. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a
I got
person.
By because my bunk mate, the condo manager, as you would call him, with the three stacks that they stack you in the pods, a black man named Bird, who was really interested in knowing about how to make a website so we could pimp out his bitches. Him
really?
Knowing that I work in computers while it's just wiring
All
and
right.
not
no,
anything
no,
to do with computers.
You, know
you
work at
mapmybitches.com. Did you create that?
Bitchmap.com.
Yeah. I milked the, I'll Ooh. Build you a website, Bird, for 7 days for protection.
That but did like you follow through with this
that
website?
Sounds like a great app idea.
No, I got the fuck out of
there. He's going to kill you.
He's going to kill you one day. He's looking for you.
He's listening right now.
Birdman.
What if he's listening? What if he's listening to you right now?
What if he mapped you as a bitch?
Oh shit.
Maybe it's for all his bitches in prison.
Whatever, I did 7 days.
Wouldn't have to map
him
very
fuck
far,
you.
Then.
No, he wouldn't.
I'm going to be right. sad when you get killed, Dowdy. That's going to be a sad day.
Who wants the last one, Chris? Or
Give it to Chris.
Give it to me.
All right. Give it Chris with balls.
Chris,
give it to Chris the balls.
Chris
to the balls.
All right, now I'm going to need you to look into Cotty's eyes while you answer this, okay?
Okay, go on.
Give advice.
Wait. Let's lock eyes first.
Oh, we have to lock eyes first?
Yeah.
Is she still? Oh, there she goes.
Hello. Give Cotty advice on how to give a hand job.
Cotty, I've never given a hand job. So
oh,
I don't
bullshit.
Know.
Yeah,
Look, I'll just go off
job.
Of how I've done it to myself.
Yeah,
very vigorous for a short amount of time. No longer than a minute. Look, it's just in and out. That's all you got to do.
If it takes longer, I don't want it.
Just if it takes longer. No, look, I'm there to do the job. Got to finish up because I have to wash dishes later.
It's just a chore, like dishes.
You're just it's just it a chore. You just have to get it done. Yeah,
so no. If you're washing dishes later, do you have to wash your hands?
Remind me not to eat
of
at
course,
your house
Of course. Of course you have to wash your hands. I'm not a savage, please.
I'm not a monster.
I'm not an animal.
I think at that point you'd just be recycling, though.
I love doing that to this mic.
I'm glad there's webcams.
Yeah, there's a bunch of videos.
And you've never given a hand job.
Right? Yeah.
Okay. You don't ask about a blowjob. Obviously, I have experience on blowjobs.
Someone was a popular girl in high school. All right. Thank you, gentlemen.
Great questions.
Awesome job.
What the fuck, man?
That's everything we need to know about these guys.
There you go. And go to SpanSpek.
Go to SpanSpek. Yes. I wanted to pronounce that.
You got it. You got it, Mo Man.
Shut up. You wanted I know to say what you did.
You don't know shit.
I do.
He knows.
You wanted an I in there.
How do you say Mo Man in Spanish?
How do you say Mol Star in Spanish?
How do you say what in Spanish?
Mol Man.
How do you say molester in Spanish?
No. Mol Star.
Violador.
Kevin.
Did you say yellow?
Kevin?
No, I said violador.
I heard Kevin.
Violador?
Yeah, that's how you say Mol Star in Spanish, Kevin.
Does violador translate to child molester? Because that could just
Translates to rapist.
There you go.
Yeah,
there
it doesn't.
I like where this show is gone.
I love how you guys have
quiet down, my guys. We're talking about Spanish.
I really don't need a rebranding.
That means like seven words in your guys' language. Like, there's just one. I think it means
like
rapist.
We like
molester,
to pack light.
So we're all over the map.
Yeah.
That's good.
We're going to take a quick break.
Yay.
And we're going to get back on the map. We're going to get back in time.
Ooh.
Can we go back and go before we ever fucking said anything tonight?
Do we have to go? You want to go back to the future? Oh.
I want to go back to...
We'll talk about going back, Jason. Don't worry.
You'll have the opportunity.
When we come back, we're going to discuss some of Jason's tender moments.
This was a real one. This was not Tinder.
This was just text message.
Well,
I'm interested in hearing some of these.
It's a secondhand Tinder that went horribly, horribly bad.
Yeah.
And we're going to discuss a little Back to the Future and some disappointments that we have from our childhood youth to now. Kevin's got a game talk thing, whatever. I don't know. Today's a kind of a half-assed day, so fuck it. Let's move on. It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast here on Longbox.fm. We'll be here.
Listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm.
Hi, this is Christopher Walken. And, you know, when I'm teabagging your dog, I'm usually listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
We got back and update everybody. Cotty finished now two quarters or one half using core curriculum of her cigarette during the show. So of all of our breaks, she's had a full half cigarette.
Yay.
Yay. Yay.
She is just the worst.
Or now boo. It's time to talk about the important things in life.
Well, we're gonna be talking about, as everyone knows, today is Back to the Future Day. It's been punched in our face, and even USA Today put out a newspaper showing the original newspaper headline from the movie. But right before we get to that, something popped up before the show that, of course, we're going to have to bring up. Jason, it's been a while since we've done this, but I think it's time.
Dating is hard, and we here at the Dirty Dowdy Podcast want to empower you with knowledge to aid you in your quest for love.
And we have an expert.
These are Jason's Tinder Moments.
All right, so while we're sitting, hanging out outside, doing our thing, Jason, who the tender whore that he is, and the guy who's been giving us advice over the last few months, has settled down with a consistent.
With a consistent whore?
Yeah.
Congratulations. A continual fuck tour. So, I mean girlfriend. That's what I want.
Yeah, don't let him fool you. It's a girlfriend now.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
when you ask him, is she your girlfriend, his response is,
No.
That sounds like
it was a genuine sigh.
It was much.
Like officially exclusive.
It's like
well, not exclusive.
Mm, as long as if there's more than people involved, as long as it's a group, it's okay.
Okay.
Okay, hold on. As far as the exclusive things goes, I asked him about that. He said, we're in an open relationship. And I'm like, mm-hmm. So you can bang chicks? He's like, yeah, she's okay with it. And I'm like, and she can take some dick. And he went,
so open.
Yeah.
What if you have a part of that?
What's that?
Of that dick taking that she takes.
Yeah, what if you take it
too? What if you have a part of that?
See, that's what Dowdy is convinced that she's training me for.
Just but. Take the dick, dude.
I mean, I have more men in my bed, so
I think you're headed down the road of double dicking in the bedroom.
Mm. Hey, that goes with those three threesomes that you've got offered on that.
They were all girls.
They want you to take the dick.
Okay,
they were all girls.
There was a point
it's
here.
It's on OkCupid. They're all transvestites.
So
that's a good point.
Before the show, I'll set the scene. Jason's chatting with his girlfriend, and Jason, who has zero filter and likes to awkwardly put things out there, did. And Jason, what happened?
Well,
give us the rundown.
This is one of those times where I actually felt some kind of regret, which doesn't happen.
Amazing.
A lot. Yeah.
This makes me so happy.
Yeah, it's your girlfriend.
that's how you know you have a girlfriend is when you feel regret.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. No, she was. She said she was going out to the bar tonight with her dad, which I've never met, and she said something along the lines of. She sent me a picture of them drinking, so I knew they were, you know, having some, probably, I can only imagine the conversation she's had, because you said no filter. So I say, with the great instinct I have, I said,
wait for it.
ask your dad what his strategy for a three-way is.
Well,
Joel, it was a joke,
judges.
But apparently, when you don't have a filter, everything is just it just goes. It's like word diarrhea. So out it went, and I didn't think she was gonna say it. But then I got back. He thought you were asking for him, you, and someone else. And I just prayed that someone else wasn't her, because that would be really weird.
I believe on the internet they call that wincest.
Have you seen some of those films, Molstar? Is that part of
end up dying?
I think I'd have to. That was
kind of a prerequisite for movies I'll watch.
Yeah, so that'll make the whole meeting for the first time real fun. I don't know how I get past that.
That's love right there. Well,
good job with that one, man. Yeah. Keep thinking, as you clearly do.
Yeah, see, this is why I should just stick with Tinder. And...
Yeah, that's what you were made for.
Mm.
Well, I'm happy to know that the biggest slut in our show is officially engaged. He just doesn't realize it yet.
What?
Mm. And your meeting with Daddy is going to be so much fun.
Mm. Oh, my gosh.
Can we do that on the show?
No.
I want to be there. I want to be at the bar with you when you meet him.
Bring him a 25-ouncer.
I think...
Just put it on the table in front of him?
Yeah. Make sure you go to a bar that sells tall cans.
Bring to the party.
Just, here
join
you go.
The family.
And just be like, this is my gift to your daughter.
Every other day.
These are my jeans.
I really hope he never knows what this podcast is and knows how to go back.
They're probably talking about it.
Actually, I'm chatting right now, and on November 11th, the Dirty Dowdy podcast is going to bring you Jason's girlfriend's dad.
All right.
Dad.
Nope.
To talk about love and life.
Mm-mm.
And how to get threesomes.
I'm tuning in.
Well, this all came to be that he said, well, being Back to the Future Day.
Yeah, I just wish I could go back in time right now.
10 minutes?
Now it's we're at about 3 hours.
You could have just blamed it on your autofill.
You could have said someone hacked you.
You could have said it was Dowdy typing on your phone.
You can go gay from here on out.
Mm-hmm.
And then give it a shot. Then you'll have plenty of threesomes.
Just go for the DILF.
Yeah.
What's awesome is that your girlfriend actually did it. She did it to you.
Yeah, that concerns me. That means that's not good.
Does her mentioning a threesome to your dad mean that she's actually into a threesome at some point?
That's already happened.
Yeah, we've done that.
You've done that? Yeah. Holy shit! Have you talked about it already? On this show?
With her dad?
No. In general. Have you talked about it on this podcast?
Oh, yeah.
Because
yeah.
I would love to hear the details.
You can go back 2 weeks, three weeks.
You can listen to the recordings. But
oh, shit. All right. I have to look at that to listen to the podcast.
I believe it's mentioned pretty often.
Masturbate so hard to that shit.
That's
I don't know how to take that.
And shit,
that's
just
a compliment. Look, you're a good looking dude. I'm just gonna go for it.
All right.
Who's this stranger?
Speaking of good looking dudes,
who's this Sasquatch that just jumped
in?
Hey,
speaking of incest, have a seat, Kenneth.
Yeah. So going back in time, Kenneth just showed up in his DeLorean from hell.
He looks like he just got out of a DeLorean.
What was his name? Hey. Doesn't even want to talk.
Stumped him.
How are you doing, Kenneth?
You got to put the big black thing next to your
head. Oh, I did rugby. It's fun. Ha ha. Beer.
How was class? How was class tonight, Kenneth?
Fuck
tell
you,
us,
that's
tell
how.
Us about your, oh, that's how the day went? Did you take a test last week and find out it fucked you?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
Are you pregnant?
Did it somehow think you smoked pot?
Yeah.
I didn't have a leaf this week.
It was a poppy seed.
All right, let's get on a topic. Kev, Molstar.
All right, so speaking of all the Michael J. Foxness, this is a roundtable question I'm going to open it up with. What would Michael J. Fox tell Marty McFly in 2015? Hit it.
He would say...
He doesn't have a stutter, for fuck's sake. He just can't
no,
move his
No, it's
arms.
Not a stutter. It's a body jiggle.
No.
It's a body jiggle.
He's like sitting on one of those beds jiggle. You put a quarter in.
His body's like a fat guy on one of those, you know those old belt shake things to help you
oh
lose
God.
Weight? He's got an invisible body shake thing going on.
Well, I didn't mean for it to go there. Yes,
yeah,
I
won't be able to get that out of my head.
Yep, I'm going to need to drink this whole bottle.
Yeah, take it down, right down the throat. Mm-hmm. You're having a great time.
Deep in your throat. Mm.
No, I mean, everyone kind of slam-killed that the whole Back to the Future thing and all of its predictions and stuff like that.
So
all
let's
over
do
TV.
It, too.
So let's do it, too. No, yeah. Let's do something else. Something very close that I'll just, you know, ride the coattails of. This is a list of movies that predicted the future. Correctly, or at least pretty accurately. And there's probably more to it, so throw it in.
Got it. Let's do it.
Let's see. Airplane 2 actually predicted naked body scanners in one of their gags.
They did, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, yeah. I like the drinking problem the most. That's my favorite part about that movie.
Oh, yeah. That whole movie is the favorite part about that
so
movie.
So I see it influenced you.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, there was
that's
wine.
Why I spill so much.
You know, I've gone through one of those multiple times. And it's not just the scan. When you get hit in the scan, like you go through it, there was nothing on me, but you still get the tap, tap, come by here, sir.
For a second there, I thought you were talking about the drinking problem.
No, no, that definitely. yeah, no, being pulled aside and forced to strip down to your boxers
you
and t-shirt.
You got the wrong color skin.
Yeah, dude, what's wrong with you?
Because you're Mexican?
Yeah, white privilege my ass.
Yeah, yeah. I guess you were the you were their quota for the
day?
Yeah, they were their affirmative action.
He was the last guy in. Hey, we only need one more.
You know,
shit, we didn't rape enough, molest enough white guys today.
My favorite one with dealing with them, after I got tired of going back and forth to the East Coast, it was like the eighth or ninth time going through this whole thing, which I get picked every single time, like I am a Muslim. And as they're...
I guess Dowdy is
right.
The guy's
Arabian.
The guy's down
like
on his knees feeling me up, and I just lean my crotch towards his face and wiggle and say, you like it? You
most,
like it?
Most take action it. You got all month, huh?
Yeah. I'm sure he doesn't get that all the time. Yeah. Up again. Now down
hours.
Again. Now up again.
Next movie.
Smell my balls.
Is that the next movie?
My Cristo balls.
Total Recall predicted self-driving cars.
Wait.
More or less. I feel like there was one earlier than that, though.
The
Jetsons. Sure.
Now that I think about it, you'd
no,
be
I
like...
Think, didn't they drive in the Jetsons?
No.
But up
no.
In the it air, was, didn't they?
They were flying.
They flew.
That's
well,
they were flying
they
cars,
were,
not
they still
flying
pilots. Yeah. All right, so the hell with Total
nice
Recall.
Try.
This is good.
Touch interface from Minority Report. However, Johnny Mnemonic got that shit years ago, right?
No, he plugged into his skull.
Yeah, but didn't he still do all the shit with his fingers?
You know, that's kind of...
That could be taken so many
I mean, if you want to go back, you got to go back to Star Trek and shit like that, really, though. I mean, you got to go back to older stuff like that.
Star Trek was doing, like, the 3D...
Yeah, if you go back all the way to fucking HAL, what was it? The fucking... I can't even remember.
HAL?
Space Odyssey?
You mean where you've seen fat women as skinny?
No, Space Odyssey. Not Shallow HAL. fucking A. No. 2001 A Space Odyssey. Yeah, they have little tablets that they were touching and talking to, actually.
Well, they had the tablets, but they didn't have like the... You know,
oh,
like
that's
a,
no. They don't, that shit
the
doesn't.
The screen where they just manipulate.
No, that's
it with
not
the
real, though.
Are we taking this to movies that are talking and their future prediction arrives around 2015?
No.
Or just future in general?
I think just future in general.
Okay.
That does kind of change the stakes.
Yeah, I want to know what I've been promised for now and why I have to be rage.
Well, there's no hoverboard, so we can
no,
rage
there
on
is.
That.
There is.
Yeah, did you see IKEA's advertisement?
Fucking guys.
IKEA?
Yeah, they put a board on a bunch of Swedish meatballs, and you can ride down hills on it.
Mm-hmm. For about 2 feet.
Yeah.
The Jetsons. The Jetsons predicted the robot vacuum. That was pretty cool.
Oh, yeah.
Roomba.
Yeah.
Roomba.
You know what's funny, though, is they had a robot like washing the dishes in the sink, and they didn't even predict a damn dishwasher.
I want my vacuum to wear a Swedish maid outfit.
That's what we have Mexicans for.
I want my vacuum to wear a maid outfit.
Swedish maid outfit.
You know those?
That was Rosie.
Those Roombas are great until you have an animal that shits in the house. Because then
just spreads.
Scares it.
Because then it just looks like a Jackson Pollock painting.
And then Weird Science, they predicted 3D printing at home with vaginas, which I'm sure was the first thing it was actually printed on a 3D printer.
I would hope.
A bunch of nerds. That's why they did it. Like, we can't afford pocket pussies. Let's just build our own.
The friction, man.
Yeah. They build our own for thousands upon thousands of dollars.
Well, now we can get what we need.
They're about four.
We can't afford a $30
you wouldn't. Hold on. Alex, you had a 3D printer, right?
I still have one. Yes.
What was the first thing you printed?
A square to calibrate it.
That was great.
That's even dirtier.
It
would have
been
vagina.
Wow. It would have been better if you printed a vagina.
Can we go back in time for just like 10 seconds?
Yeah.
It's more of a teardrop.
No, I mean,
you want to re-answer that?
No, I mean,
it was a gun. Really, you cool. Printed a gun, right?
I really wish I could have, because those things are, you know.
What was the second thing you printed?
Oh, I didn't get it calibrated right.
This cube didn't come out. It was a triangle.
Yeah.
So your future came and went with no success.
Oh no. I mean, it was a fun project, and it's right now it's at one of my brother's houses, so that's why I don't have it right.
Printing
now.
Up tons of vaginas.
No, he printed a Star Wars, a stormtrooper themed doorstop.
That's like a door vagina. That's like a nerd vagina.
Yeah.
Stormtrooper vagina.
Yeah, sure, that's close enough.
So we got this great technology, and people are printing stupid shit like cubes.
You know, that's actually...
Apparently, Kevin's prints a rhombus.
Yeah, pretty much. They don't use it for printing vaginas.
It'd be like, man, we just
they
invented
don't have
a time machine.
The size for it.
Oh, I want to get in it and go watch myself have sex 2 minutes ago. Like, of all the shit you can do with a time machine,
why would you go back 2 minutes?
That'd be 30 seconds of time travel for you.
Yeah, you're judging that. Like, you're giving yourself a 1 minute and a half way too much.
You're going to go back in time 2 minutes
the recovery
and then wait for
period.
Dowdy, what was some stuff that you thought was going to come true?
Everything Idiocracy, and it's come true.
We're getting pretty damn close.
Brando.
Yeah.
It's
what the plants crave.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now, I know Cotty actually saw that movie, and she said, no, I don't like this. I think
real?
That was her critique.
Because it's true.
Word for word.
Yeah.
What about the Dirty Harry episode when he's talking to his little watch thing? When he's doing all his...
Dirty Harry
or
episode?
Dick Tracy. Dick Tracy.
Sorry, shit.
Way off. Holy fuck, that was I'm talking about his snuff porn.
The double D's, you know, they both threw me off there, but yeah, no.
They usually
do.
Double
the
D's should throw most people off.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Just you, Kenneth, man.
Mostly you, Kenneth.
I expected arcades to be a lot more badass.
I expected arcades to be here.
Yeah.
I'm still sad that they're gone, yeah.
Payphones, too.
No, I'm all right with payphones being gone.
I'm still bitter about the arcade from my time there. Every time I would ride my bike, I'd save enough money and get to go to the arcade. And the one game I always wanted to play was Street Fighter II.
And I love that game.
They'd have like 6 or 8 Street Fighter II arcade games. So I'd get to the one in the back corner of the entire place, the darkest corner, like the most child rapey corner that you could find in the arcade. And I would line up and I would start playing. And I'd get like 3 enemies in.
Next to a soiled mattress.
And I know the only thing I did was Ryu because Chung Li, because if you just hit a button fast enough, you get the special power. I couldn't figure out the A, B, up, down,
that's
and blah, blah,
you were
blah.
Stupid. That's why you're bad at sex.
But yeah, just give me one button. That's all I need.
Up, down, down, left, right, left. Yeah.
You like Chung Li because you had a short skirt.
I would do Honda.
He has a short skirt too. You would do Honda.
That's right. Short skirt too.
No,
that's
I'd
why
get,
you have Kenneth on
I'd
the podcast.
I'd get into the damn game, and then 3 guys in, this little Asian kid who would always bring a stool, by the way, would come up.
Yeah, that's veteran.
He
right
can
there.
Barely see over the controls, but it's like, you have a new challenger. And I just knew within 30 seconds I'm going and finding a new game.
Because he'd whip your ass.
Yeah,
that's
like
why.
Instantly. It wasn't even fair.
He's like, your quarter, fuck your quarter.
That's why I hated arcades.
I knew the ass whooping was coming. I just didn't know what form in this story. I thought you were going to say, I saved up up all my money and I went to the arcade, got my ass kicked and robbed.
No, I had to settle for that stupid scooper thing that would slide back and forth and not coins because I needed tickets so I can buy a goddamn keyboard because that's the only thing I could win at the arcade.
Wedges and ledges, baby. He's just the cocaine of quarter sucking.
I think that's the new hashtag.
Wedges and ledges. Yeah.
Hashtag wedges and ledges.
Whatever happened to Galaga?
It's there.
Still there. Still that's there. The best answer you could have given me.
It's there. And thank you for participating tonight, Nick. Enjoy your beer on the way out.
I will.
What other? Okay, future movies.
Yeah.
What else do we got? Now I know right, back
did,
to the
did
future.
Did we go through everything you had already?
Well, the rest of them suck.
Well, let us be the judge of
let's hear your shitty ideas.
Space Odyssey, Skype, little video con. That's like in a shit tip. But that's that, one of the problems is that they didn't really predict it in this year, though, because they actually predicted in 2001, and they were
a little off.
They had video phones back then, but they were horrible.
Yeah, yeah.
It was the worst thing ever. Only rich people bought it, and it was like Laserdisc. There's some rich people somewhere that has a basement full of Beta, Laserdisc, and video phones.
They're not rich.
Not anymore.
The people who bought the wrong shit. You know, they're trying to sell video discs, Laserdiscs. These things are like huge, man. Like 14 inches in diameter.
Yeah. It's a giant.
Damn right.
You had to treat them like radioactive waste, like transporting them.
It's
like,
just a giant target.
Shit. Yeah.
That's all it is.
Slot, shut up. Slot, shut up. I see it. Shut up.
I could have said a lot of things, but I didn't. I restrained myself.
Let's see. Electric Dreams in 1984.
Envisioned. What kind of movies do you watch?
This is just a list. That's all this is.
All these paranoid crap.
Somebody else gave you this list?
They predicted home automation. Oh. You talk to your walls and shit.
Home automation's been around since like 1984.
And they judge you.
The walls judge you.
Yeah, I don't like judging electronics. Yeah. Like when Siri gets uppity.
Yeah,
not a fan of that.
That's where it's all going to go.
Dirty bitch.
Smartphones and PDAs. Star Trek, the original series, obviously.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
With the little boopy bops.
They predicted they don't cell have the phones. They
still don't have the
tricorders
yet, but you know, one day.
Yeah. They've started on something.
Yeah, they actually have.
They have something going. And they allowed black people on the bridge.
Yeah.
Good
yeah.
for them.
They were ahead of their time.
They really did. They did predict the future.
Good for them.
Yep.
And interracial sex, if we're going
That's
there.
That's correct.
Are we including sex tapes?
They ruled the galaxy.
Movies? Blade Runner envisioned digital billboards.
I thought it was the fake people.
They got that one pretty good.
Yeah. That's, yeah.
But when was Blade Runner supposed to take place in?
I don't know.
20-something-something.
It's far off, yeah. Androids and shit. And
I'd say 15 years before Han Solo got his Millennium Falcon.
I think you're about right.
Yeah.
How many parsecs is that?
Six and a half. 6.34.
Parsecs is a measure of distance, dumbass.
I know that. That's why. That's the joke.
Fuck.
Wow. And the time-honored classic War Games predicted...
Do you want to play a game?
War driving or like automated drone attacks, you know, attacking from computers.
Blade Runner takes place in 2019.
Thanks, Wikipedia.
Damn.
That's right.
Yeah, that was Wikipedia.
They weren't that far off.
This was brought to you by
What are we going to do, Running
We're
Man?
Very close.
That's actually 2017 is when Running Man's supposed to happen.
Running Man?
Fucking 2019. Mm-hmm.
I hope.
Don't waste all your GBs.
Is that guy dead? The
Harrison
guy.
Ford is dead, yes.
No, Richard.
Harrison Ford.
He's dead
rest
inside.
In peace.
The Family Feud guy who ran Running Man.
I don't fucking
yeah,
know.
I think he is.
The Family Feud guy, the one that committed suicide?
Oh, he did?
What? Which one? The first one?
I don't
the
know.
Original?
Either way, he's not running anymore.
That's true. He's dead.
Now he's rotting. Thank you. It's now so he's rotting.
You know, Running Man. Running Man, you know.
Say goodbye.
That's the guy who made out with everybody on Family Feud, right?
No. Well, Running Man, I mean, predicted what? Like reality TV for the most part?
Yeah. Pretty close. I think he just predicted Jersey Shore.
shit shows. Keeping Up with Kardashians and crap like that.
I hope it goes the right way.
I really
just
hope
kill
it
everybody
does.
On
Speaking
Jersey
of
Shore.
Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Lamar Odom has now been transferred to L.A. And
fucking horrible.
And
play your Wookiee sound already. Come on.
And
we just want you know. I know you want to play. Just fucking
no,
do it.
I'm not gonna do that.
His plane didn't crash.
Good old Wookiee.
Chloe's deciding his future.
The Wookiee Kardashian is deciding his future. Yes.
Did Terminator ever come true?
Not yet. We're waiting. Skynet's on the way, though.
Cool. All right.
Yeah, they are coming out with AI crap. Right
and Schwarzenegger.
Okay. You know what is really interesting, part. Though, is watching a movie, any movie made before 2000, where nobody has a cell phone.
They have to run to payphones and shit.
Yeah. Well, they have to talk to each other and look at each other. It's a completely different world.
You know, I watched Back to the Future not long ago, and I looked at they have the part where they drive by the gas station, and I was like, man. Fucking 89 cents a gallon or some shit like that.
Yeah, that was a lie.
Fucking A.
Yeah.
That was in the future?
No, it was in the past.
Oh.
Wait, which past?
the real past.
Okay. What? Let me bring up time travel.
When do we want it?
That's you already did.
No. Okay, a question came up on my Facebook timeline questioning the logic of the time of the time travel in Back to the Future. So, when Biff takes the DeLorean and grabs the almanac and goes back in time to give it back to young Biff. And then he shows back up in 2015 with the DeLorean and everything's still normal. Isn't that a flaw in the timeline?
You know, man, I don't really give a shit.
That's
I think
good
he's
answer.
Right.
Well, this has gone well tonight. Thank you.
Know, it's a movie. There's suspended disbelief anyway.
Well, I said trying to understand.
We could have drove a DeLorean, for Christ's sake. Who buys a DeLorean?
I've been in that DeLorean, actually.
No, you've been in a replica of that DeLorean.
No, the DeLorean. I was at a Star Trek festival.
Oh, that seems kind of...
Yeah, it was just there.
Star Trek festival.
It was there as a
you are the and you coolest. Call me the nerd, for fuck's sake.
I'm DeLorean sorry,
was
Connie.
The patron.
He was a red shirt, though, so it's okay.
Yeah,
he died pretty damn quick.
No, screw you guys. I assassinated two Klingons.
Oh.
And God. Then I got held captive in a Klingon Shakespeare room until my mom saved me.
Klingon Shakespeare?
You said your mom and Klingon. That's interesting.
Okay, rugby boy.
Still better than...
Is this why you're going to college?
Still better than your story.
This is what they're teaching you?
I feel like we just Sesame Streeted this whole thing.
When your mom found you, did she laugh at
what's
you?
What's the next one you've got on the list?
Well, since I was trying to avoid all of that.
No, we're just going to, if we got to, you know, this is, you know, this is like that train wreck that you watch happen. You just can't look away.
Yeah, here we go. Here
we're
going to
keep
car.
Talking about these shitty stories.
The 1929 movie Woman in the Moon predicted space travel.
Really?
Oh,
that's
really?
Never actually happened.
That because of them. Before.
That's a pretty common reference. I'm glad we included that one.
Well, you're goddamn welcome. Go back to
have you seen that movie, Kevin?
I've never heard that reference before. That's not a common reference at all.
That's the point.
No one's talking about Woman on the Moon.
Part of me.
Who talks about
space
that?
Space travel. Space
I
travel.
I talk about that every time I get up in the morning.
Kevin can't shut up about it.
Shut up!
This motherfucker. Let me look at my list.
Oh, Jesus
fucking
Christ.
Fucking Chicago Dog can never talk about this.
And the movie Sleeper from 1973. You know that movie, Jason. Predicted robot-assisted surgery. But not robot-assisted hand jobs, so I did not watch it.
I have a feeling that we have gone off the rails.
I think we might have.
I don't think there needs to be three more.
We precursed this segment with a disclaimer that it was going to be half-assed, and half-assed it was.
Yes.
I think this is like quarter-assed.
It's not done yet either. That's the best part.
No, I'm out. I think that's all.
You're calling it?
Yeah. No, I don't have any left. Airplane 2 predicted naked body scanners.
That was
we did that.
I know, but I'll keep going if you want.
What do we want? Time travel. When do we want it? That's irrelevant.
Oh my Bam. God!
Are you happy?
Fuck
I'm
you!
Happy.
You got that in. Joke in. Nice job.
I wanted to.
Fuck it.
The timing on it was. You think you need a time machine for that timing?
I think I need a time machine so I don't have to fucking get this segment again.
Hey, so we're gonna take a quick break. And come back, we're going to finish up the show with possibly the Tardies, since our lead Tard is here. It's a Dirty Dowdy Podcast here on Longbox.fm. We'll be right back.
Make it drop.
listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast. Online on Facebook. Just hit up our Facebook page for all things Dirty Dowdy. That's facebook.com/the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to finish this show. Can we go back in time and not do this show?
Sure.
But, of course, SpanSpek will promote that.
Yes, of course.
Just not the rest of everything we said or
the
came out of our
mouths. The show was amazing, Dowdy. Dirty Dowdy.
Why, thank you. You're clearly a fantastic liar, and you know how to flirt with the ladies.
Kiss ass.
I know how to flirt with you, Dowdy.
Yeah, baby.
You and you.
He already blew your mic earlier.
You guys can't use my bed later.
I'm going to use your fucking Harry bed, and I'm going to like it.
I've already been through enough. What's the worst that's going to happen when they're in it?
It's already got Dowdy's AIDS, so I guess it can't get much worse.
Yeah, blue on black.
Speaking of AIDS, how you doing, Slot?
I'm good.
So tell you what, he's had no prep, nothing possible to plan this out. So here's a chance to highlight Kenneth and give him a chance to look good. It's time for the tardies.
Holy fucking ass crackers! I am back. Thank you everybody for your applause.
Boo.
Yay,
cocksucker.
I gotta take a dump.
With 10 minutes of actual of showtime and no prep, as Dowdy said, I've got a few best ofs for tonight. So.
I didn't applaud.
I've got some lube if you need to prep.
I think you're a piece of shit.
Yeah, that's great. Speaking of which, best shitbag of the night goes to Chris Dowdy, so great job, you fuckhead.
Yay.
Everybody fucking hates Dowdy. Yay. Fuck him.
Isn't that the name of the
show? I feel that you're negative.
Everybody hates Dowdy.
Only at you. So anyway.
Have you considered therapy?
Yeah, didn't take.
Dowdy, I think there is a show named that.
I like you, Dowdy.
Shut the fuck up anyway. We got
I said I like him.
We've got hashtag of the night. So I've only heard one hashtag of the night, so I just decided to make up a couple of my own. We had one hashtag that said wedges and ledges.
That was pretty good.
Yes. That's in the running. What we also have one that I came up with saying time travel is fucked. But we have one that I made up on the spot, also called Michael J Fox. So.
Ooh, that was me. I win.
Actually, that was me.
No. I did.
But I'm going to give it to wedges and ledges because that was an actual hashtag of the day. So that goes to, I believe, Kevin.
All right.
Yay, Kevin wins something.
Yay.
I like the fake competition you created.
I don't feel like you're really behind the spirit of this.
No. Well, we do have a best of for lame ass of the night.
Sounds like you wrote
one
this
that
10
I came
minutes
up. Yeah, really? No shit. So lame ass of the night goes to a very special person for a stupid ass time travel joke, and that goes to Alex.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
For a well-timed stupid ass time travel joke. Thank you for sneaking that one in at the last second.
If it's a time travel joke, can it get away with having bad timing?
You already tried that.
You see what he did there?
Yeah,
you tried that earlier.
It was time.
So anyway,
that's Jason's method. He just keeps trying the same thing until it succeeds.
I'm just going to force it until I'm finished.
Story of my life. If I wrote an autobiography, that would be it.
That's the Bible of a creeper.
How to Force It by Slot.
Force It like a prom date.
We also have a best boobs of the night, and we have some competition tonight, so I'm going to give it as a tie for Melissa and Cotty.
They're the only boobs.
For being out here tonight. Good sports.
How socialist.
You're very welcome.
For your solid black shirts. Great job. And then we have the MVP of the night. This one goes to a very special person who I'm told has a special talent. And this, I think a couple of you know this one already, but this I'm going to give to Chris Balls for getting hella blind chick poon. Blind chick poon is the all-time MVP for everyone. Thank you, Chris Balls.
Yes.
You are a testament.
Thank you, Sasquatch.
You are a testament to mankind.
Thank you, Sasquatch.
Is that you throwing the ball in the picture over here? That looks like you. Is that you?
Is that on your autobiography?
He is the tardy.
Are you the quintessential tardy?
Dang
me. That's the photo on your Wikipedia page.
That's his Tinder profile.
Yeah. Oh, that's
this is the tardies brought to you by Ken. Fuck Ken. I mean, Dowdy, take it away.
Who won tonight? Woo.
Chris Balls.
I did. Chris Balls.
Well, Chris Balls.
Mr. Chris Balls himself.
You get 1 full minute to talk about whatever the hell you want, and ready, set, go.
Let's fucking do this. SpanSpek Music. Oh, shit. SpanSpek Music and Arts Festival this Saturday in Orosi, California, over at the Orosi Memorial Hall. $5 all ages beer, craft beer, 21 and over, with a bunch of bands, including Lance Canales, Tokyo Death March, and Basura, Kaleidoscope, St. Eggs. All the bands you could want goes to high school scholarships. It's a good cause. I hope you can make it out there.
Now say it in Spanish.
Hola. Now
you know how we
do it. Eso, you racist bastards.
Sábado. His boat just crashed.
Si se puede.
That's Cuban, you motherfucker.
Oh, trust me. They can swim.
Can we get a translation?
No.
Go forget it. Thank you very much. Thank you, Dowdy, for having us on here.
That's all right.
No problem.
Thank you, Dowdy.
Next week, guys, we'll be back and dumber, and look forward to that. We're gonna have some old friends of the show from back in 2009. They were Triple Vega, down to Maddox, but next week we get to name their new band. They've decided to give us naming rights to the new band.
Are you serious?
And anyone listening, you can start coming up
Is
with
the
band
flaming
names.
Fetus?
Midget Pussy.
Oh, man.
I think I got a whole room full of people who are just going to start lining up ideas for this band.
Yeah.
We are going to name a band next week. That's all going on. After that, we got Chuck Leonard from KAIL.
Sweet.
He'll be part of the show as well. That's all going on. Again, everything you heard, SpanSpek Festival. Go enjoy Christopher's...
Crystal balls. It's Chris
Duballs.
SpanSpek Festival.com.
It is Chris
it's,
Balls.
It's Christopher's Immigration Festival.
Balls.
And Chris's that's going balls. On.
Wear your bulletproof vest.
Come get your green card. Come get your green card at our festival. That'll $5.
That was the name of Dowdy's last marriage.
Could you work that? You should have a green card booth.
We do have a green card booth. Just
fantastic.
Come
you are going to have thousands of people there.
Oh, shit.
That's all sponsored by Obama. Thank you, Obama.
Yay.
And with that, this is Dowdy saying for everyone here in the room.
Word.
Is that the word?
Crystal balls.
You've been listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm. The opinions expressed on the Dirty Dowdy Podcast aren't necessarily those of staff, management, or sponsors. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast is a presentation of Longbox.fm.